Hello everybody, in this video I'm going to show what kind of work I did in order to achieve that the aliens are moving a bit more sophisticated around the battle area. So basically the idea was that the alien starts somewhere. There is the door. I created 10 door positions. I mean 10. And basically the aliens first chooses the closest target. When it reached around 5 or 6 meters, then choose one free target, but from this first row of targets first, and then from the second row. I created the second row just to make sure that in case there are aliens still approaching towards the end of the game, they can still choose some target. And so they are choosing this, and this will be their final position. They are going to reserve it, and one by one they fill up this space in front of the door in order to attack it. So how did I achieve it? I decided to go for creating a behavior tree, but not from code, but using scriptable objects as well. There was a great tutorial in the Unity Learn page when someone created state machine implementation with scriptable objects, and I would like to create something similar to that, but instead of a state machine I would like to create a behavior tree. I put some links in the description below the video where you can find some nice introduction to behavior trees. So the behavior trees are like trees which are controlling an agent's behavior. I'm going to show you what I'm using here in this scenario. So we are obviously having a root node, and this root node is going to be like a selector node in this scenario. Because first, we are going to check if the agent is dead. Because if it's dead, then it's going to falling over. And then it's going to sink below the ground. And if it's alive, it's going to attack the door. And the attacking door means it's going to select a closest target. And then approach that target. Then reserve a door position. And then it's going to go to that door position it had been reserved. So what I decided to do is this behavior tree, it looks something like that. The selector node I mentioned earlier. It goes through until some the first of his children returning successful. Each time the whole tree can have three states, running, failed, and successful. And the selector node goes through if is dead is failed, because the agent at the beginning is not dead, then move survived attack door and check if it can go for success. And if the attack door becomes success, then the whole tree becomes successful. The attack door is a sequence node, meaning it expects that each of these children are going to be successful. And if any of these children are going to report failure to it, it is going to report failure to the root node. The is dead node, actually I made a mistake here, because the is dead node is a conditional node, which means it's going to execute the beneath child, which is the death sequence, only if a condition is true. Meaning, in this scenario, if the alien is dead, then it's going to execute the death sequence. So this is a conditional, this is going to be a sequence. You can represent a graph or a tree structure in many ways. What I choose to do is to represent these tree in the following structure. Each node is going to have three pointers. One is going to be pointing to the parent. One pointer to the left child. Which means that the leftmost of its children. And one pointer to the right sibling. Which means that this is the right sibling of this node. The reason I choose this representation, because in this way we can always keep track of the current node we are at, and we don't have to traverse through all the tree when we are processing the tree. We can just have to keep a pointer to the current node of this structure, call the process method of that node, and that process method is going to return what will be the next node in this tree. So in this case, the root node obviously doesn't have a parent. Its left child is that conditional node, and it doesn't have any right sibling because it hasn't have any siblings at all. The is that conditional is going to point to the root node. The first child will be this death sequence, and the right sibling is going to be the attack door node. The death sequence is going to have one child. Obviously, the parent is going to point to this death sequence node of the children. The fall over is going to point the sink below ground. It's not going to have any children. The parent here is going to put up there, and it doesn't have any children, any siblings, the sink below ground node. So this is going to be empty. I misdraw this line, because this is supposed to point to the parent. So this is going to be the is that conditional. This is going to put toward here, and it doesn't have any right siblings. The attack door is a sequence. It's going to put the root node as a parent, and the left child is going to be the select target position. And it doesn't going to have any right siblings, because it doesn't have any. Obviously, the parents are all pointing toward the attack door. I'm not going to do this fully. Any of these children doesn't have any child, because these are all action nodes. In the behavior trees, the leaf nodes are the action nodes. They are going to do whatever it has to be done. And these nodes doesn't have any children at all. The right child of the select target is the approach, and the right child of the approach is the reserve door position, and the right child or this is go to door, and the go to door doesn't have any more siblings. Sorry, right sibling. This is what I meant before. I kind of hope that this introduction help us understand what we are going to code here. The advantage of this, as I mentioned before, that we only have to take a pointer of the current node wherever we are in the tree. Obviously, to set up this node system is going to be a bit complicated, because you kind of have to understand these relationships as I what I draw with the green pen. But I hope this is going to clarify what we are going to do. For this approaching target stuff, we are going to use the NavMesh components, the NavMesh system, but we are not going to use the NavMesh components, because the project now is very simple, and for the time being I feel that we don't really need the extra capabilities of the NavMesh component system. So in this scenario I just make the all the relevant objects, navigation static. All the building left are navigation static, and the ground is also navigation static. The buildings in the navigation system are not walkable, obviously, and also I marked the simple turret stand not walkable either. And I also added a NavMesh agent to the alien model, to CCO. And I pretty much set this as the default for now. It seemed work quite well to be able to use the set destination for this NavMesh agent. I think that's it for this introduction. As you can see, the NavMesh surface has been set up because I've already baked it. And the next part of the video, I'm going to explain how I created the behavior tree for this scenario. So thank you for watching, and goodbye for now.